us to who he is. Hallelujah, my provider. Hallelujah, hallelujah, at peace. Hallelujah, my Lord. Hallelujah.
Barbecue that was prepared for you or whatever your family made. I hope that you enjoyed it. Our family enjoyed our barbecue on yesterday. I like fresh barbecue when I come from church. So I barbecued on yesterday. Amen. Amen. And I know that I said last week that today would be Women's Day, but something very special is being planned for you. So just give the ladies a little time and then we'll bring that to you. The women of excellence are on hiatus, but the men of honor will meet Tuesday night, July 16th at 7 p.m. in the Fellowship Hall. We are asking that you come out and support the groups by adding your own special flavor to the mix. New members class, which was canceled last Friday due to 4th of July, will take place this Friday. So come out, you new members, and those who are wanting to refresh their foundational knowledge. Ice cream, you scream. We all scream for ice cream. I remember that used to be a jingle that we had. Back when we had it, and during these hot summer months, the Founders Committee will be selling soothing, cooling ice cream immediately after morning service. So please, I hope that we have one of your favorites. Just let me know and I'll purchase that if I can. And please stop by the in the foyer Before you leave, and the Founders Committee thanks you for your support. On July 4th, we had Janet Wayne's birthday and Letitia Smith's birthday. It was on the 4th. Give them a hand. And I don't see this couple here today, but we have someone very special who is approaching a very special time in their anniversary. It is between Pastor Williams and Sister Williams' birthday anniversary. We will celebrate their 38th on October 4th. And James and Deborah will celebrate their 40th on December 29th, I believe. This will be the Browns. Don and Norma Brown will celebrate their 39th anniversary on July 9th, which is Tuesday. Amen. I don't have any visitor support, so it's all Northside out there that I'm looking at. And just stay with God, and you'll always end up in the right place. Amen. One visitor. I'm sorry, Sister Dorothy has a visitor with her. I didn't see. And I saw him when I first came in service. And I'm sorry. Would you please stand and give us your name? And where are you from? Oh, okay. Give him a hand. And Denise, is it Denise?
My husband has a birthday this month.
Oh! Is it on the 29th?
The
27th. But the 7th birthday is on the 27th. All right. Praise God.
Thank you. Amen. And welcome again, Brother Alberto. God bless you. Bless the Lord. Some of us go to your country every now and then. Glory. Hallelujah. How many are blessed today? Amen. Praise God. Thank God for all that are here today. I really enjoyed the testimonies last week. Anyone want to share briefly what the Lord has done for you? Hallelujah. Brother Holman, okay, God bless you. Those testimonies were encouraging, and we'd like to hear how they overcome. Amen.
Brother Williams, good morning, Saints. I just wanted to say that I was out washing my car this morning, and down here at the car wash at the Tasty Freeze. You know how guys kind of walk around down there, and a gentleman came up to me this morning, and it was quite early because I was there about 7 o'clock, and he had on his jeans and his t-shirts, and he was just out trying to sell phones. I mean, he had prepaid phones that he was trying to sell for $10, right? I mean, not knowing it, when the guy walked up to me and asked me about the phones, of course I said I didn't need any phones then. Then it was just something that inside me said, you need to talk to this guy about the Lord. And he had told me he was here from California. He was out there and he had been gang banging and doing all that stuff. And he went to prison. He spent 2 years in prison. And when he got out, they determined that he had a tumor, a brain cancer tumor. And, he was just out in the street, just a real, but he was a very, very humble guy. And that's what kind of struck chords with him. And, of course, we got to talking to him. I got to talking with him. And, of course, the Word of God came up, And, the kid, his name is James. And I told him, if he'd like to come with me to service, by all means, come and, share, partake of his word of it. Because God's is the only way. And he said, my grandma's has really been praying for me. But, the doctors told me I got 17 months to live. I say, well, James, that's what the doctors say. Because I serve a God who's able to heal. He's able to make alive. He's able to, keep those who are walking in disorder, I say, man, you got to give your life to him because he's the answer. And he said, man, I really want to, but, my other friends, that, we was coming up, and then they get saved, and then they get killed. I say, right, hold up. I said, hold up, right there. That's the trick of the enemy. To say, if you get saved, you're going to die. He said, then I seen it in my life. I seen my friends who gave their life over to the Lord, and then they wind up dying. I said, James, that's not God. That's not God. And he don't want you to believe that way, because he's a God of life. And he wants to give that to you right now. So, to make a long story short, we just prayed, and you know, I told James, I said, hey man, I'm going to come to service, and if the Lord brings it up, which it came up through Donnell, I said, man, I'm going to come to service, and if it comes up to where somebody should give a testimony, I'm going to give a testimony about the character of a young man out there struggling on the streets who is really a humble person, but he's just out on his own. I mean, but it's the love of God that's been keeping him. And it's the love of God that has saved him. But he doesn't know it, but the man is saved and he's got a call on his life. But he's a wonderful spirit and a brother. I mean, you would look at him and you wouldn't see that. We kind of look at people and judge them by the way they look. But I guarantee you, when you get to know people and talk to people and you find out their problems and you find out, you know, that they just need the Lord. So, in your prayer and doing worship, you know, thanking that brother, his name is James, and that God will bring him into the fold, because he would be a great soldier for the Lord, and I know he will be. So God, thank you.
Hey, amen. Wonderful, wonderful. Praise the Lord. Okay, anyone else want to share? Amen. Come on, sister. God bless you. Glory. Hallelujah. Stop pinching that, baby.
Good morning. I know y'all heard me last Sunday, but I have something else to say. God gave me a gift, and I received that gift. But he wants me to make a move on that gift, or he has nothing to work with.
Amen.
So I'm so glad to be back. Everybody takes a little vacation, you know, but I'm back to stay. And I was so glad when Sunday morning came. I was up at 5 o'clock. You know, I was going walking my little niece when it came again. But I want to share that God gave his only begotten son for our sins. You know, God loves unconditionally. We love. But ain't nobody out there going to give their kids up for nobody's sins. You know, so I studied the Bible, but I put my own version in it. I used some of my own version. I know what God wants us to break the bondage of stealing, robbery, and everything. So as long as I keep on reading the Bible and keep God on my mind every day, I cannot go wrong. Because if I look in the mirror in the morning, and he's satisfied with me, everything I touch will be blessed. So that's all I have to say. Thank you.
We'll come on this time. Hallelujah. God bless. Hallelujah. Amen. Be one more. Any more? God bless. Amen. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Let's give the Lord a hand for what we heard this morning. And all that's happened so far. Hallelujah. Amen. We're going to prepare ourselves for giving at this time. Go ahead and receive today's offering, your contribution.